Ross Duncan and I'm 15.
I'm Eric Kilianek and I'm 16 year old.
Alan Smith and I'm 12 years old.
I'm Oliver Dern and I'm 17 years.
I'm Drew Phillips and I'm 18.
Nathan Smith, 16.
Jordan Bernie-Hoff, 16.
Graham's Harrison Curtis, I'm 19.
Sebastian
Woody,
18.
The thing I found good about your trailer was the music. I found it interesting because it's just like it fits the like film really good.
I found that there was loads of scenes like showing like what's going to happen in the film. Like most film trailers don't actually have that.
Trailer was very impressive, and I think the best part that made the trailer the best was probably the camera angles.
I quite like the editing techniques, how it sort of like flashed across the screen, and also with the titles coming up, like the effects that all happened. The storyline was, you know, quite interesting.
It had good acting and had an unusual theme that hasn't been done before much.
It was good, some of the shots and like the edits were quite well timed.
I found that the trailer was very ominous and very well put together.
I really like the music in it. I think music is one of the most important things in like movies in general, and all the dialogue in it was really effective.
I quite like the variety shots and how there is a storyline there. So I quite like that.
To be honest, the way that kind of just focus on CCTV cameras, it doesn't like have any like actual dramatics in it yet.
Too many camera, like CCTV footage, like scenes. There should be more like footage of the actual scene and where it's set.
All I could say that was bad about the trailer was the fact that the music didn't really sync up with sometimes the trailer.
Not too sure, to be honest. I think it was quite good, to be fair. There wasn't a lot that I saw that was wrong with it.
Some camera angles were a bit iffy and made it feel slightly amateurish,
instead of having more of a build to it.
I very much agree with that.
There's no build-up. I was kind of waiting for it to be like a drop, but it never happened, but I still enjoyed it.
All the voiceovers and the sounds and stuff, because you get to the end of the sound, it sounds good, and then it just like cuts off, it doesn't like fade away or anything. It's quite obvious that it was like just put on top.
Would you pay to watch it in the cinema?
Yes, I would.
And would you pay to watch it in cinemas?
Yeah, I'd say it's quite interesting. So I definitely want to go see what the rest of the story is. Like, I'm not sure if it would be scary for me personally, because I, you know, tend to watch a lot of horror, but it would be definitely a film that I would want to go and see.
And would you pay to watch it in cinemas?
I would give it an 8.
Yeah, I'd go with that.
And would you two pay to watch it in cinemas?
Yeah, I'd give it a 8.2.
And would you pay to watch it in cinemas?
Yeah, I'd pay for it, yeah.
About 7.5.
And would you pay to watch it in cinemas?
Yeah. No, I don't think it does. It probably suits 16-year-olds, but probably not 18-year-olds.
I do.
Thank you, Joe.